Well, we opened the doors. We didn't have a lot of air service, and then you start looking. Okay, now we, you know, the old saying, "You build it, they will come," didn't fall true with that. The only jet service we had at that time was U.S. Air, and they pulled out on us. So we have a few puddle jumpers in a new, brand new, state-of-the-art facility, and we were scrambling.
Rice hit the road, meeting face to face with airline representatives. He had a hard sell. Though their market studies proved they had the demand for air service, flying daily to and from Flint wasn't exactly attractive to airlines at the time.
And I think the real turning point for our airport was when we convinced AirTran, at that time was ValueJet, to start service here. And I'll tell you exactly what happened. They started service here, and they didn't do real well in the beginning, but they started doing better, and more passengers. Well, guess what part of the country we live in? Northwest Territory. At that time. And they were not going to let another airline come in here and take away from their domain. So Northwest put on more flights. But guess what happened? We filled those. And then lo and behold, so AirTran added more flights, Northwest added more flights. All of a sudden Delta said, hey, we're not going to let this happen too. So Delta started up. And guess what? We filled all those flights.
After a long struggle, Bishop became Flint's Cinderella story. The planes continued to fill up, and a strong partnership developed, playing a key role in the airport's success. Brooks Patterson and his team in Oakland County, an economic engine just 10 minutes south of the airport, helped Bishop become the regional airport it is today.
We couldn't keep up with the growth. You know, we were growing at 15 to 21% a year. We couldn't build parking lots fast enough. And again, those were challenging days also. We expanded the terminal four times. To accommodate the growth. So, you know, we went from 100,000 passengers to 1.2 million passengers. It was just people, I don't think, even realized it.
I'm still a little bit awestruck. As I drove in today to the parking lot, I saw all the cars here, and I saw all the people of the community that are using it.
But the work isn't over. With lots of room to grow, the challenges, though different, remain.
Our market studies, for example, show we have the potential of about 2 million passengers, and we're, you know, only halfway there. So those challenges will always be there.
After 24 years as the airport's director, Jim Rice is passing the baton and preparing to embark on a new challenge of his own, retirement.
So I guess October 8th or 9th of 2014, I'm going to roll over and not have to come to work. My challenge at that point will be to make my wife happier.
On October 9th, 2014, almost 21 years to the day since the opening of the new terminal, a new airport director will officially step in.
Well, nobody's going to replace Jim Rice. His role in the development of this airport is, you know, going to be an important part of our local history. The challenge is, where do we go from here, and how do we build on Jim's great work and continue to grow the airport in a way that it fulfills its mission to our community.
I see a bright future. I think, you know, my replacement, it'll be their responsibility to maintain good staff, good leadership, work with the city, the county. The Oakland County is a big part of our development. That person works with them and the staff. Again, potentially, we're only halfway there, so I'm optimistic.
Jim Rice has brought this airport up to speed. He's a forward thinker. He gets things done, and he's active in the community of getting people, and I think he's wonderful. I enjoyed working with him through the years. I think that our great-grandfather would be so proud and glad that he donated this land. I think he would be very pleased. It's helping the community.